Hi guys, in the last few lecture we were discussing the pulse width modulation techniques which enabled us to control the output voltage of the inverter. That is, if we use pulse width modulation then we can vary the output frequency as well as the output voltage of the inverter. In this lecture we will see a few problems on the concept that we have learnt in the last few lectures. So in our first problem it is saying a three-phase fully controlled thyristor bridge converter is used as line commutated converter to feed 50 kilowatt power into 420 volt DC to a 3 phase 415 volt 50 hertz AC main. We need to find the RMS thyristor current. So if you see, it is based on fully controlled thyristor bridge converter. Okay, line commutated inverter means rectifier but with alpha greater than 90. I know in a rectifier thyristor current is equal to I naught by root 3. Why? Because any thyristor conducts only for 120 degree duration out of 360 degree. Okay? Then that means first I need to calculate this I naught. Now I have been given the power as well as the DC voltage. So I can calculate I naught. It will be 50,000 by 420. How much will this come out to be? This will come out to be 50,000 by 420 is actually 5,000 by 42. So this becomes 119 ampere. Then what will be the thyristor current? It will be 119 divided by root 3. So it will come out to be 68.73 ampere. Okay. So you have to remember this concept of line commutated inverter. It is very important. It is very frequently asked in the gate examination. So do not confuse between the concepts of the inverter that we have learned so far and the line commutated inverter. Do treat line commutated inverter just like a rectifier but with the alpha greater than 90 so that output voltage is negative. In our next problem it is saying an inverter has a periodic output voltage with output waveform as shown. When conduction angle alpha is 120 degree, this is actually also my pulse width. Okay, now we need to find the RMS value of fundamental component of output voltage V01 RMS. We saw the Fourier series was 4 VDC by n pi, so it will be 2 root 2 by pi VDC sine d sine pi by 2. Why 2 root 2 by pi? Because we are taking RMS value. So 2 root 2 by pi VDC is given to be 1, D will come out to be 60, sine 90 will also be 1. So this will come out to be 0.78 volt, that is root 6 by pi, okay, because it will be root 3 by 2. Then in the next part we need to find the value of alpha for which converter is free from fifth harmonic. If it is free from fifth harmonic, then 2D is equal to alpha, then, or we can say that D is equal to pi by 5, that is 36 degree. Then what should be the value of alpha? It is equal to 2D, it should be 72 degree. If pulse width is 72 degree, then it will be free from fifth harmonic. Otherwise, you can also keep D is equal to 2 pi by 5. So it will come out to be 72 degree. Then alpha which is equal to 2D will come out to be 144 degree. And since it is less than 180 degree, it is perfectly valid. So alpha can have two values, either 72 degree or 144 degree. In next problem it is saying, a single phase voltage source inverter is controlled in a single pulse width modulated mode with a pulse width of 150 degree in each half cycle. So 2D has been given to me as 150 degree. So D becomes 75 degree. We need to find the THD. So first we will need to find the distortion factor. We know that V0 RMS is VDC under root 2D by pi. And V0 1 will be 2 root 2 by pi VDC sine D. So that means distortion factor will be 2 root 2 by pi sin d divided by under root 2d by, if we take in degrees, 180. So this will come out to be the distortion factor. So it comes out to be 0.95264. Then if we calculate THD, it will actually be under root 1 by g square minus 1, which will come out to be 31.9%. Okay, so that will be the total harmonic distortion for a pulse width of 150 degree. In our next problem, it is saying a single phase inverter operated in PWM mode generating a single pulse of width 2d in the center of each half cycle as shown in the figure. It is found that output voltage is free from fifth harmonic for pulse width of 144 degree. Okay, that I just derived. If the pulse width is 72 or 144, it will be free from fifth harmonic. We need to find the V03 max upon V01 max. It will be 4 VDC by 3 pi sin 3D over 4 VDC by pi sin D. Why I'm not taking a factor of sin n pi by 2? Because sin 3 pi by 2 will be minus 1, sin pi by 2 will be 1. But we are interested in just the ratio of magnitude and not the signs. This gets cancelled out. So it will be sin 3D upon 3 sin D. Now pulse width 2D is given to me 144 degree. That means D will become 72. Sine 216 upon 3 sine 72. It will come out to be 0.206. Okay, or it is 20.6%. Actually, there will also be a minus sign. So what you can do is take like this 3 pi by 2 sine pi by 2. So it will be minus, then it will come out to be plus. That is 20.6%. Okay, but anyways, we do not need to care about the sign because we are interested in ratio of magnitude of the voltages. In next problem, it is saying in single pulse modulation of PWM inverter, pulse width is 120 degree. So 2D is 120 degree, which implies D is 60 degree. Now it is saying input voltage of 220 volt DC. Okay, we need to find V01 RMS. It is actually equal to 2 root 2 by pi Vs into sin d sin pi by 2. That will become 2 root 2 by pi Vs is 220, sin d is sin 60. That is root 6 by pi 220, that is 220 into 0.78. Root 6 by pi comes out to be 0.78. That is 171.6 volt. Okay, so as I told you, even you might have by now observed that most of the questions on pulse width modulation are from single pulse width modulation, and that too they are based on the Fourier series for single pulse width modulation. In next problem, it is saying in single phase VSI bridge inverter, I naught is given as 200 sine omega t minus 45, that is, it is just the fundamental. Then it is asking if supply voltage is 220 volt, we need to find the power. Now, to determine the power, we will only take the fundamental component of supply voltage because the current only has fundamental. So, we will take fundamental voltage. Otherwise, what will happen, if you take any other component, the power will be zero for those two combination. Like fundamental current and third harmonic of voltage, both multiplied will give us zero average power. That's why we only need to take fundamental. Let us first find V0 RMS 1. It is a single phase VSI bridge inverter. So it will be 4 into 220 by pi root. Okay, that is 880 by pi divided by root 2. 4 Vs by n pi. So it will come out to be 198.06 volt. What is IRMS 1? It will be 200 upon root 2. That will become 200 by root 2. 141.42, and it is in milliampere, 0.14142. So what will be the power? It will be VRMS IRMS cos phi. 198.06, 0.14142 cos phi will be cos 45. Okay. It will come out to be 19.8 watt. Okay. So that is the power drawn from the supply. In our last problem, it is saying the single phase full bridge inverter VSI shown in the figure. It has an output frequency of 50 Hz. It uses unipolar PWM with switching frequency 50 kHz. As I told you, even in case of sinusoidal or any other PWM, carrier frequency is much higher as compared to reference. So this is your reference frequency and this 50 kHz is the carrier frequency. Now modulation index is given to me as 0.7 volt. Anyways, if I ask you one thing, how many number of pulses will be there? It will be FC by 2FR. That will come out to be 500. Okay. That why this FC and FR are important. Now we know that the input is 100 volt. We are given the values of component L, C and R. We need to find amplitude of fundamental component in the output voltage. That is V0. First of all, what is the amplitude of fundamental in VR? As I told you, in unipolar PWM, the fundamental amplitude at the inverter output is VR1, that is M into VIN, that is 70 volt, 0.7 into 100. But now this is across VR. We need to find it across V0. It is fundamental component, so its frequency will be 50 Hz. And for any sinusoidal input or for any sinusoidal quantity, inductances and capacitances are replaced by impedances. So first let us calculate impedance of inductor, omega L, 2 into pi into 50 into L is 9.55 millihenry. This will come out to be 3 ohm. What about XC? 1 by omega C, 1 by 2 into pi into 50 into 63.66 microfarad. This will come out to be 50 ohm. Now this resistance and capacitance are connected in series. So Z equivalent will be R into minus J by omega C, R minus J by omega C. That is 5 into minus J 50 over 5 minus J 50. So it comes out to be 4.975 angle minus 5.71 degree ohm. Now if you want to find the voltage across the load, we just apply potential divider. V0 is equal to VR Z equivalent over JXL plus Z equivalent. So VR was 70, 4.975 angle minus 5.71 divided by 5J5 plus 4.975 angle minus 5.71 degree. Okay. So this comes out to be 62.77 volt. So that will be the output voltage of the inverter. Okay. So this problem uses the concept of unipolar PWM, but you have to take an additional step, that is use potential divider to determine the output voltage. Okay. So such kind of problems can be framed from the PWM, out of which most predominant is the single PWM technique. This is all from the inverters. So now you have a fair idea of about what kind of problems can be framed.